Shalom, brethren, sistren, Rastafari. I am Rastafari. I just wanted to add this little regarding the Levitical readings and kind of connect some of these points in this series of videos. The at-one-ment, the atonement. This all relates because it has to do with law. And so, what I think that the Holy See and the judicial system is putting into play is these sacrifices. So now, to cover is the atonement is to cover the legal. Is the legal sacrifice covered? Like, we offend and we commit sin, and divine forgiveness covers our sin. Jesus Christus covers it for us. Now, in the image of the beast, we are like a straw man. This is how I've through scripture, this is how I think I can explain the straw man. It's not the blood of the vein, it's not the blood in the veins of the sacrifice, but the blood upon the altar, which is efficacious, you could say, which means to produce an intended effect. And since scripture doesn't really identify the fact, the truth that all this is intended in I and I living as closely as possible a life of holiness to Jah as Jesus Christus, the example. So scripture does not know this. All it knows is that someone was placed upon a cross and crucified. And upon this idea, it's that is the substitute for the offender, which is I and I. If I and I are imitating and seeking to be a type Christ to the fullness. Now, for example, going into the word kapar, it's like a cape to cover, to pass over. It's like, so we need not to be in front of a judge because we're covered for. It's like we're redeemed. But we don't know these things. And so this is how Leviticus and what's going on with the straw man and the corporation is it's that link. These are like, Chapter 19 goes into the laws and whoever eats the blood of the flesh will be cut off and stuff like that. Well, those are the vampires, the leeches, the system. They leech off of I and I. And I and I through ignorance cannot, you know, my people perish for a lack of knowledge. Now, if we don't know that, it's like, when we're in court, it's like they're putting that straw man, they're putting the animal type. They're sacrificing the animal type. And when our sins have been covered, really. Now, example, the cost has been paid. Jesus gave his life for I and I. And that covers all of our sins. Like, I remember New Testament, it says, him that seeks to save his life, the same shall lose it. But he who loses his life, the same shall save it. So, yes, lose our lives in the sense that our selfishness, our ego, and be holy to Jah will, and he will be with I and I. if I and I make our wills obedient. So this is kind of like living in the image of the beast. Are we going to take on that personality of an animal and be that sacrifice upon the altar? Or are we going to claim our inheritance and be covered, you know? Be covered by the grace of Jah. And the cost has already been paid. In fact, they owe us, man, because, you know, Jesus is of extreme value, and so there's nothing this system can provide for us that'll ever, you know, replenish that which was paid. Well, you know, let me just continue, and then everything on the other portions of scripture that I've included in this presentations are, if you go through chapter 19 and chapter 20 of Leviticus, it's kind of breaking it down, but in the balance, the good judgment, the sacrifices that it'll be, the not to like the commandments, and then not to make molten gods or images of these so-called gods, and not to, you know, I should go there, but, well, I only have a little bit of tape left, so I'm just gonna try to get as much out of this. Now, another thing is that, remember Rastafari and the fivefold? Well, it's kind of the sacrifice that I and I are to make. I don't think I got them right because I couldn't find them in my notes. But it would be, I think, if, and correct me if I'm wrong, I very well could be. But let's, to give an example and to give an idea of what the fivefold, it would be like humility. And then time, to sacrifice our times, to sacrifice the I, the self, and be one I, be of one hope, one destiny, one aim, obedience to Jah, and sacrifice of property. And so, these are the sacrifices that if we make, then we need not to sacrifice animals, we need not to take on the image of a beast and be judged by unrighteous judges, whatever, that have no right. And so it's basically, I'm sure I didn't do a good job explaining that, but it's what's going on. We're taking on this name of a corporation when we should be taking on, we should be reclaiming our inheritance. Now, because the world is Jah's, and we're only lending them. The governments, I and I lend the government this land so that they could perform their services, and they use our resources supposedly to benefit I and I. And yes, they need to collect taxes from their own people revolving around their own little system. They have to tax their little policemen, their little national security, whatever kind of imagination roles they play. They are to tax them to pay I and I. Because this is I and I in land, our promised land, and they've just kept quiet, and they're not letting us know that. But, you know, like, they're good businessmen, you could say. They're not gonna tell you.